Dave Reif and Tony Pedregon from the 30th Menards NHRA Heartland Nationals presented by Minties. We're in the capital city of Kansas, Topeka, with a little qualifying recap that in pro stock turned a little bit madcap on Friday during the second qualifying session. Right side of your screen, two-time champion Erica Enders. Left side, 19-year-old rookie of the year from 2017, Tanner Gray. It's Erica that goes low at 6.625 seconds, but this is where it gets interesting. Get to the top end of the race course, two cars are going to turn off, and they're going to get dangerously close.
Well, for starters, right here, Tanner Gray, watch him. He's going to apex this turn. Erica Enders has the right of way. In fact, she is being signaled for her to take the lead around the corner.
But then here comes Tanner. Whoa. That led to a lengthy conversation once both drivers got out. Neither driver really yielding any ground to the other driver. Let's see what they had to say about this incident.
When he says stop, I'm committed to go.
To which way?
He holds the flag for you to stop and then waves me. So I'm committed to going, right? I'm coasting with no brake. No brake. And you just cut
the brake.
I'm sorry?
Why
don't you listen to what the f*** I'm saying? It's simple.
So here's how I look at it, right?
Okay.
Is I pull the chutes, I look at the left side, you're beside me.
Why do
you
think
back.
He stands up there? To try to get hit going into the sand?
Maybe. I mean,
he's
that's what he
puts
the
stupid.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
F*** it, buddy. It's all right. It's an NHRA drag race,
sweetheart. Don't call me f***ing sweetheart. No, I don't have a problem with the kid. I mean, he mouths off or whatever, but he only knows what he's been taught, and that's not his fault. You can't take away the talent that the kid has, but like I said on the interview that I did with you on the NHRA Today app thing, sometimes it's better to keep your mouth shut and listen.
She got out and thought it'd be a good idea to cuss me out, and to be honest with you, I had no idea what I'd even done wrong. So, it kind of caught me off guard. I guess I just expected more class out of a two-time champ, but... You know, it is what it is. Like, I guess you think she's entitled to something since she's won those two championships. Apologized to her at least two or three times down here. And then I also walked down to their trailer and apologized to the team owner, Richard, and all the elite guys over here. I have all the respect in the world for them. I don't really have any for her right now. So.
As a two-time champion, Tony, you know the adrenaline is at its highest right at the end of a run.
Well, in Tanner's defense, that's really the only thing he has to stand on.
Final qualifying session brought Tanner Gray alongside of Greg Anderson this time. Still, though, with Erica firmly in control of number one. But note the gray skies that kept this track a little racier than everybody expected.
Track temperature comes down, the grip increases, allows these cars to get a little bit better bite. The laps times reflect that.
6.620 seconds, Greg Anderson took away the number one qualifying spot. But here come Erica in the final pair with an opportunity to grab it back. Running alongside the American ethanol runner, Derek Kramer. And while all eyes were focused on the E3 spark plug side, did anybody see Derek Kramer stealing away the number one qualifying spot in this pass? Did you see it? I didn't.
Derek Kramer, about half track, probably realized that he's got a chance.
6.613 seconds. And for the second time in his career, second time this season, Derek Kramer leads the NHRA Pro Stock Ladder presented by Lucas Oil. He'll take on Will Hatcher in his Pro Stock debut, a D5 comp runner, as Matt Hartford takes on Jed Coughlin Jr.
Any very interesting scenario if Erica advances, if Tanner advances. Maybe they can settle their differences in the second round. But Tanner Gray is going to have to beat Bo Butner. The other tough matchup, Vincent Nobil and Drew Skillman.
Funny car coming your way next. We're at day number one. It was Courtney Force, the advanced auto parts car, running alongside of Cruz Pedregon. Courtney, no problem qualifying number one. Has done it multiple times over the past season and a half. But Cruz Pedregon is definitely turning the corner. This particular pair, though, it's all Courtney. She drops the hammer, 3.911 to set the stage for day number two. But Cruz Pedregon, as I mentioned, is definitely no slouch. He came back in the third session and did what nobody else could do.
Well, and you see some clouds rolling in, but really didn't affect the track temperature. It's 115 degrees, and one of the very impressive things with that snap-on car in the other lane, opposite of Courtney Force, the only car, Dave, like you said, to dip down in the sub-4-second range.
Cruz Pedregon definitely has a car racy tomorrow. Look out for him for Sunday eliminations. Courtney Force able to hold on to the number one qualifying spot, but an interesting moment in the fourth session as Tim Wilkerson found himself alongside the Mopar machine of Matt Hagen. See if you can figure out where that interest comes from. Boom, right there.
It looks like the car spun the tires, revved the engine up, poured a lot of fuel in the motor, and something internally happened from that point on.
Courtney, though, able to hold on to the number one spot as she will take on Rich Townsend on her Lucas Oil ladder. Matt Hagen, Tim Wilkerson, what is note on the bottom half of the ladder? Cars without lane choice, that's where you find three world champs, guys like Robert Hight, John Force.
You got a couple more here. Ron Capps taking on Sean Langdon, a big matchup between Cruz and Robert Hight, and then Tommy Johnson out qualifying John Force.
Next up, it's Top Fuel. We're in the second qualifying session. A great moment for the son and father, Steve Torrance on the left, Dad Billy on the right. It's the two Capco runners with Mama K standing right in the middle. Well, it's Mama K that's the ultimate winner. She watches her son go number one, husband slide into number two spot. She's plenty happy about day one qualifying. We thought that would stick, but then again, think again. David Grubnick, the tuner for Clay Milliken, had other ideas in that strutmasters.com car.
Sun beating on the racetrack means there's some temperature in it. I don't think any of us expected a run this quick. Maybe not even the tuner for this car.
And all it took was 3.739 seconds to change the course of Top Fuel as Clay Milliken, David Grubnick grabbed their fourth number one qualifying spot of the year. For his efforts, he gets the Nebraska runner Terry Totten. As Tony Schumacher, Leah Pritchett, and Tron Brown, three cars in the Strong Don Schumacher stables, are all on the same side of the ladder.
And you see Brittany Force against Richie Crampton, who made his best run in the last session. Billy Torrance and Kevin Kinsley and Terry McMillan against Mike Salinas, two of the highest rising cars in Top Fuel right now.
Not 1 hour, not 2 hours, not 3 hours, but 4 hours of continuous coverage from the NHRA Heartland Nationals. Begin with NHRA Today at 1 Eastern. Right on the heels of that, 3 hours of final round coverage as we go racing for real at the Heartland Nationals here in Topeka, Kansas.